Esto es lo más duro para un hombre. Saber que lo más importante de la vida de un hombre se va.
Manuel Gámez is living a nightmare, watching his life unravel. He's saying goodbye to his 13-year-old daughter, who's been on life support since she attempted to take her own life in early July. And the pain of knowing his attempts to cross the border failed to make it in time is just too much to bear.
Que me perdone si le fallé. Que me perdone. Porque no podía estar en ese momento que ella. Tal vez necesitaba mi consejo.
This family's story captures the often excruciating reality of desperate families separated by a border. In 2014, Manuel Gámez was an undocumented immigrant who had spent 7 years living on Long Island, New York, working as a mechanic. His father was taking care of his daughter in Honduras.
Manuel says that his father was killed by MS-13 gang members in 2014 for not paying extortion bribes. And then after that, he decided to send his daughter here to the United States to live with family members in New York, and that she was granted asylum.
Gámez thought if his daughter had been granted asylum, he would as well, but he was denied. After that, he crossed the border illegally twice, hoping to reunite with his daughter, who was now thriving, learning English and dreaming of a career in medicine while living with his sisters. But Heidi would often break down in tears because she missed her father.
Ella lloró muy triste, dice, papi, tú nunca vas a llegar, siempre te agarran. Y yo le prometí, hija, esta es la última vez, que yo lo voy a intentar y Dios me va a la oportunidad de llegar.
Jessica and Zoila Gámez García are Heidi's aunts. Zoila was the one who discovered her after she attempted to take her own life. Earlier that night, Heidi was distraught over learning her father was once again caught by Border Patrol and was being held in an immigration detention center.
Yo sí siento que no la supe cuidar bien. Yo sí siento que en algo fallé. No sé qué fue, pero no sé por qué.
Gámez was given an ankle monitor and a 2-week humanitarian parole so he could see his daughter one last time.
Do you regret sending your daughter to the United States?
Y no me arrepiento porque si yo no hubiera hecho nada por moverlos a ellos, cuántos casos que yo conozco que ya las jovencitas allá terminan violadas y muertas. No me arrepiento porque yo lo hice con sabiendo que aquí van a estar seguras.
After his daughter's funeral, Manuel will return to detention in Texas. He expects to be deported back to Honduras, where he says he has no family to return to.
Yo soñaba con enseñarle a conducir, comprarle un carro, que fuera a la universidad, que estudiara. Pero ya, los sueños ya están terminados.